Good morning. So this video is for English 133, which is this. I think that most of my students already went and picked it up. I know that some of them told me. If you have not picked it up, it's vital that you go pick it up. For my evening students, which are all together as well, I don't know what the book room hours are. I was only given hours during the day. So if you don't mind calling and seeing what the book room hours are for the evening, that would be great. If you can't figure anything out, call Valeria at the office and ask for her, and she will be able to, you know, to better guide you, because I don't know. So it's important that you have your book. I've done the grading for the introductory video. I've also done the grading for the daily attendance. If you got a zero, that means that you didn't upload, so make sure that you upload, and I will give you credit for that. Make sure that you read chapter one, right? And it looks like this. And within chapter one, hopefully everybody has their book, and it always takes forever. So let me know down in the comments below on this video, right, if you have your book or not, so I can sort of do a rundown on what it is. But okay, so for those of you who have books, this is going to be your assignment. Your assignment is to read chapter one, and you are to do page three, which is personal feedback. Let me say that again. Page three in chapter one, which is personal feedback. And then we go to page seven, which is a weekly time chart. This is really important because sometimes we complain that we don't have enough time and that we don't have enough time. We don't have enough time, enough time. So this is crucial for you to do this appropriately and to take the time to do it. It's going to be for every single day starting at 8 o'clock. If you do the same thing over and over, like, you know, if we were going to school from 8 to 5 or 8 to 3 or whatever, then that would be blocked off. So if you go to work from whatever time you go to work, then that's what it is. So make sure that you block that off. Here it doesn't state how much you use, how much to put in time for FaceTime and social media. Your phones to track what kind of screen time you do. And so check out your screen time. My screen time is pretty high up, and I'm pretty productive. So so make sure that you check on that. And I've been pretty shocked. I really need to cut down on my screenshot because I look at a lot of stuff that I shouldn't be doing, like YouTubing and all that or whatever, that has nothing to do with school and nothing with to do with my other YouTube channel. It has to do with just watching stupid people doing stupid stuff. And so don't waste your time. Don't waste your time watching other people live, right? You live your own life. So make sure that the page seven on your weekly time chart is done. Now at the bottom of that page, you need to make sure that you count the total hours of class. So the equivalent to your class time, which is going to be, you know, difficult because you're sort of not going to know, right? Because we're not physically there, but each class is assigned a certain amount of hours. I think that at least for my class, each class is worth like 1 hour. And so in physical time, we would have been meeting for my class for an hour. So you add up all your hours. If you have like medical stuff, medical classes or whatever, some labs are worth like 2 hours or stuff like that. So try to figure that out. Hopefully you'll be able to figure that out. And then if you'll notice in the bottom, it says times two. That gives you the amount of hours that you should be studying per week. You're going to be shocked. But really, if you want to be an extraordinary student, that's the time you need to put in. So you're going to have to put in a lot of time for studying if you wish to be an elite student. And then moving on down, I want you to go on to page 23, okay? Make sure you read everything. Instructions are everything. I had students, you know, do uploads, and they were uploading whatever the hell they wanted. They didn't follow instructions correctly. So make sure that you read the instructions. So this is about your reading rate, which is important to see. Now, on the previous page, okay, I don't know if you can see this, it has exercise 10, and it's backwards for me, so I hope you can see it. Okay, I think right about here is where the instructions are, increase reading rate, okay? And then you read this, you're gonna time yourself from here, which is reading 3, common causes of college stress. And you're gonna go all the way to here. See my notes? I'll show you this about later. After you set up the time, there's gonna be a little chart here, okay? You need to state how many minutes and how many seconds you have. This will give you the chart to be able to change over your minutes to your seconds. So you can use your timer. It says there to use a partner. We don't have a partner, and everybody has a phone. In the back, there's questions, okay? This is on page 24. You need to answer these questions in order to make sure that you got your reading rate appropriately. Excuse me, I have my braces. I believe that you are only allowed to get one wrong out of these five questions. If you did not get one wrong and you got more, then that means you did not have the appropriate comprehension. The deal with that is that it doesn't matter how fast you read, but if you cannot comprehend, then you will not be able to get through it, because it doesn't matter how fast you read. If you don't understand it, then you're gonna have to go back and reread it. And this chapter is very, very important, and I usually spend about 2 weeks on it because it's a super important chapter, okay? So we're not gonna spend 2 weeks on it. So make sure that that's appropriate. Now, after you have read and timed it, you are going to go online, okay? And you're gonna look for this article under Forbes magazine. And it says, do you read fast enough to be successful? So after you've timed yourself, after you've read and you've answered the questions on page 24, and you've timed yourself on page 22 and 23, and there's a little chart there that you have to convert, then after that you go online and you look for the article named Forbes, titled Forbes, do you read fast enough to be successful? In it, it will give you a list of different levels of where you rank. Don't be scared. Everybody ranks super low, and that's including myself. When the other day, my students is like, how about you, miss? And I ranked really, really low. So you're going to be very shocked, and that's sort of appropriate. There's people that think they read really great, and they don't. I read excellent, and I still scored really low. But check it out. You need to understand what it is. Also, in that little, I think, essay or that article that you read, there's a little timer, which is what I did because I couldn't read this one because I had already read it. So if you've read something before, then it's sort of, you know, not good in reading rate because it's not going to count. But in the Forbes article, I think that it gives you a click, like rate yourself or whatever. You can do that as well, and it'll tell you what it is. I had a hard time, and you know, I'm making that as an excuse like everybody else, right? Because I couldn't see. Because I'm kind of blind. It's a long story. I'll tell you guys later. But I couldn't see the article, the passage that I was reading. So it took me forever to sort of focus in and out, and then I couldn't expand, and so it was a hot mess. So that's not under good conditions. So I rather recommend that you sort of, you know, read whatever it is that you can read here. So that is your assignment, okay? We'll see how you guys do tomorrow. Today, we'll see if you can finish it off today. If you're not, then you'll have till, what's today, Wednesday? You'll have till Thursday. But let's see if you can finish it off today and see where you're at. I'm going to put up links to this. In case I don't put up the link, then somebody will remind me. Now, I don't like to put up the links. If we had a regular class, we would usually upload at the time of the class because these are classroom assignments. And if you're here, that's when you get to upload it. Also, if I put up the link, it sort of messes up the grading system, and it sort of minimizes the other grades because that grade still has not been linked and has not been put there on this view. So what I'm thinking is that, I don't know what that was. What I'm thinking is that I'm gonna put the links and then put them available. So long story, I might put them up yet tomorrow. I might put them up tomorrow, or I might put them up today. Okay, so I hope I didn't confuse you. All right, let me know. If I did, just send me a little bubble. Great, super day, ciao.